Here at VisualDx, we're making it easier for you to both broaden your differential and get to the correct diagnosis quickly with a couple design changes. Here's the differential of a 27-year-old female with vomiting, abdominal pain, delirium, headache, fatigue, and a rash. Aside from the way diagnoses are now arranged in tabs, at first glance, the diagnoses themselves are shown in a familiar way, using a photo, Symptocon, or radiology image. Let's take a closer look at some new features. Each diagnosis now has a match strength indicator under its name. This tells you how many of your findings match the diagnosis you're considering. West Nile virus and Rocky Mountain spotted fever, in this case, match all 6 findings. Their match strength bars are green and full. Streptococcal pharyngitis matches 5 of your 6 findings. Its match strength is yellow and the bar isn't full. Quickly discover which findings don't match by hovering over the disease. Delirium is not connected with streptococcal pharyngitis and is crossed off in the list. Underneath the image or Symptocon are icons that quickly show you more information about the diagnosis. A plane indicates a diagnosis that can be travel-related, so Rocky Mountain spotted fever has a plane. But there's a catch. If you add a travel finding when creating your differential, the plane icon won't show up because VisualDx already knows you know you're considering travel. If you don't put in a travel finding, but the diagnosis could be travel-related, the plane will show up. A pill indicates a diagnosis that may be caused by a medication reaction. Another icon you might see is a radiation symbol, which indicates a diagnosis resulting from chemical, biologic, radiation, or nuclear exposure. The camera shows how many disease photos, Symptocons, and other images we have in our database for that disease. There are 33 images connected to Rocky Mountain spotted fever. You can view your differential in different formats. We're in photo view now. This is the Symptocon view, and here's how the list view is displayed. Now you can also use the default view to see a mix of images and Symptocons that best represent each diagnosis. Learn more about diagnosing adverse medication reactions using VisualDx in the video Medication Adverse Events.